In this lecture, we will discuss about the method of solving Poisson's equation. The objectives of this lecture is to obtain expression for potential in the region between conductors of a parallel plate electrode system. The region between the parallel plate electrodes has volume charge density. And also, we will try to obtain the expression for electric field in the region between the conductors. When we have volume charge density in the region between the conductors, we have to use Poisson's equation for obtaining the solution of potential between the two conductors. We have to use Laplace equation when the volume charge density in the region between the conductors is zero. Some of the examples where the volume charge distribution exists are vacuum tubes, magneto hydrodynamic energy conversion devices, etc. Now we will discuss about the steps in solving the boundary value problems, which involve Poisson's equation. We have to solve Poisson's equation by using direct integration method when the problem is of one-dimensional nature. A problem is said to be one-dimensional when the potential is varying as a function of only one variable. Now, we have to apply the boundary conditions to determine a unique solution for a V. Because when we do the integration in step 1, we will be having the constants of integration. These unknown constants of integration can be evaluated by using the boundary conditions. The third step is to obtain the electric field by performing negative gradient operation of the potential. Now we will take the example of a parallel plate capacitor. Here, the area of the plates is assumed to be very large. The lower plate, which is at z is equal to 0, and the upper plate is assumed to be at z is equal to z1. The potential of the lower plate, which is at z is equal to 0, is V equal to 0. And the potential of the plate at z is equal to 0, 1 is given by V is equal to V1. And the region between the two plates has volume charge density, which is given by rho naught. In this particular case, rho naught is a constant. One more important point about this problem is that the potential is not varying with respect to x direction or with respect to x direction. The potential is varying only in z direction. That is, the potential is varying from V is equal to 0 at z is equal to 0 to V is equal to V1 at z is equal to z1. So, in this problem, the potential is varying with respect to z coordinate only. And the region between the conductors has a charge density, which is given by rho V is equal to rho naught. In order to solve this problem, we have to make use of Poisson's equation. The Poisson's equation is given by del square V is equal to minus rho V by epsilon naught. In case the volume charge density rho V is equal to 0, then we will have Laplace equation, which is del square V equal to 0. But in this particular problem, we have to make use of Poisson's equation. Since the potential is varying with respect to only one variable, that is z, the Poisson's equation reduces to dou square V by dou z square is equal to minus rho naught by epsilon naught. On integrating equation 2 with respect to z, we will be having the equation 3, that is dou v by dou z is equal to minus rho naught by epsilon naught into z plus c1. Now we have a constant c1. On integrating equation 3 with respect to z again, we have the expression for potential v. This expression for v has two unknown constants, c1 and c2. Now to determine this unknown constant c1 and c2, we have to make use of the boundary conditions. The boundary conditions are at z is equal to 0, the potential v is equal to 0. So at z is equal to 0, the potential here is equal to 0. Therefore, from this expression, we get the value for constant c2. Here, c2 is equal to 0. Again, by making use of the second boundary condition, that is at z is equal to z1, potential v is equal to v1, we can determine the constant c1. The constant c1 is given by this expression. C1 is equal to v1 by z1 plus rho naught by 2 epsilon naught into z1. Now, by substituting the constants c1 and c2 in equation 4, we have the expression for the potential v, which is given by equation 7. Now, to obtain the electric field between the two conductors, we can take negative gradient of the potential V. So, E is equal to minus gradient of V is equal to, we will be getting minus rho naught by epsilon naught into Z plus V1 by Z1 plus rho naught by 2 epsilon naught into Z1.